What's happening, my beautiful people? My name is Mike Lavelle. Welcome back to the YouTube channel. You watched the Euros, which I'm sure you did. I want your opinion. Let's have an open discussion. We can debate. Doesn't need to just be the finals. Use the comment section. And also flashback players. I'm gonna make that video. If you wanna be featured, best flashback players that you've used in FIFA 21. Go. Take a moment or a second or a few seconds and allow your voice to be heard. I use those. I like to poll the community. But today we have ranking team 2, summer stars or summer heat, something along the lines of the summertime. And then we'll also go over the cops and the drops later on with Ivan LaPagna. This is not based on value necessarily, but just the best of the best. Have you liked the video yet? YouTube algorithm wants to eat that up. Appetizers, brunch, lunch, dinner, dessert. We're always freestyle. That's how we like it here in these parts. If you haven't linked up with me on social, at Mike Lavelle, pick a platform. We're there daily, just like we're here daily. Criteria, simple. Summer stars, team 2 players. And this is performance-based, I'll reiterate. Not about price point, just about performance on the virtual pitch. Glad we're on the same page. Enjoy. Yarmolenko! He's built like a giant and he resembles those movements. 6'3", mud puddle level of step. Have you seen Stomp the Yard? This guy is ruining your garden in the front and in the back. Not that I don't enjoy him on the actual pitch. He's got the Ukrainian shuffle. We're not talking boards. That's a bar. That's some wordplay. We're moving onward. Sommer, nothing personal. You're just a goalkeeper. Or he's just a goalkeeper. They don't make big runs on my ranking list. The priority just isn't there. And it's so debatable person to person, experience to experience. It's as if we bought the same ticket, but we didn't get on the same ride. Lapadula, fake stats. 99.99 in the dribbling department? That doesn't air out properly. Feels more like an air ball. And when you see an upgrade from a 71 overall, silver, nothing else in between, and then to a 93, that's gonna have suspect activity written all over it. You wanna find yourself a ghost? Or you'd like to get ghosted? Haunted house. These types of upgrades normally aren't all the way genuine or authentic. Typically, this should be the rule, a worry, a skepticism. Maybe a rule of worry instead of a rule of thumb. I don't know where either of those terminologies came from. This is a newspaper with typos. You can't trust it. There was no proofreader. Torres, this is my stance. He's not going to change your squad too far this way or too far that way. So you could insert him onto the pitch or into the starting 11. You got yourself a wing player or a striker. Gonna need to be a little more of a direct line. He doesn't have some of that asceticism. Yes, I just made up a new word. We pluralized assets with an extreme pluralism. Also might be a made up word. That's what we're doing today. Dolberg. Maybe this is a transition point. I personally like Dolberg. This is a crossover. Not talking Allen Iverson. 6'2" is where some of you will struggle to accept him into a lineup. I understand. I feel the explosiveness and the power and the directness. I also like the price point, just an observation. And Dolberg played with Legos as a kid. I'm not even sure if that's true or what reference that has to do with anything. But that's what's coming out today. Fire breathing. Test run. If you wonder where this creativity comes from, I have no idea. But welcome to the channel. Mailer. That cross from the Euros. Woo, you know the one that I'm talking about. Competitive left back. Plenty of similarities to Hernandez if you enjoyed that usage rate. I'm not saying he's as good, but he should be in the discussion. You could do a compare and a contrast. You could feel it out. Move, groove, incorporate, speak to, discuss. See if the back four, they align. They're on the same page. Cavani, this will be a split room. And I'd love for you to put in the comments the number that you have him out of these 17 options from Summer Series 2, Summer Heat 2, Summer Cup 2, Summer Inclusion 2, Summer Stars. Got it. I worked my way to the destination. Just took us a while. It's as if you had options. You could have taken the subway, a vehicle, an Uber, a bike ride. We decided to walk. It was longer. But you hear and feel and understand the thought process. The point that I'm making, some of you will swear by Cavani and his finishing and his natural attacking instincts. You click with them like a new remote control with fresh batteries. Or an old remote control with fresh batteries. While others will say, this man is rotten. month-old banana status. Update that on Facebook. Mina, 6'5" reasons to complete this objective. Has Veron-esque stats, but do not expect that same level of output. I just think that's unfair. Still amazing value, and I've noticed the upgrade. I'm just not willing to co-sign to that degree. Fair enough. Harry Kane. I actually wish that EA managed a way to make this work, where he was top tier, and his passing, oh, so premium, precise. I'm telling you, this is Pirlo-esque if you're looking at Harry Kane. I'm a record that's broken, not a broken record. Talked about how he can dime drop. I'm a tape of the tails, not a tail of the tape. Looking like trees and organics, organics and trees. We're talking strange in this video. But the issue is the body type. Can't shift it even with the upgraded stats. He's still not going to be able to dribble in terms of taking on players on the edge of the box when you need to find space. But as a finisher, as a passer, as someone who will have an aerial presence, it's all there. Chiellini, am I the only player that messed with this man heavy? He's a doctor in my teams. He's been fixing the back line for a good minute. Also had the foot freeze item. This is a crazy upgrade if you really look through these statistics. Congratulations towards Italy, of course. Chiellini led that back line as well. You might not appreciate a couple of the fouls, but if you are an Italian supporter, you love this man. And if you're a center back by trade, you're also gonna co-sign or stand by and support Chiellini. Kind of represents everything from the old school. Not just the looks, but his positioning, his tackling, when to take a foul, when to create a foul, physical presence, how to facilitate out of the back. He offers you a very competitive package, even in this old age. Looking like an Italian grandpa. Alba, fastest left back in the game. And EA slapped an 82 strength, pre-chemistry style. He's zooming. He's also 5'7", doesn't have the skills, doesn't have the weak foot. So you pick and choose what you're looking for. It could be a grab bag. I could also see Alba on a stock increase or stock drop, depending who you speak to. Lucas! Ah! No complaints. This is my type of center mid, especially with the way the game transitioned. I want offensive center mids that can still play defense, but I need those skills. I need someone I'm comfortable with. He got the 5-star appreciation. That's a major upgrade. Give me some of those scoop turns or the really clean ball roll into the scoop. Attack the space. Make offense easy. Bring it on back. It's another option. And I'm also playing narrow formations. 4-1-2-1-2. 4-3-1-2. Where I need players like this that resemble some of these statistics in order for me to be able to attack in the manner and the form of expression that I'd like to have. I feel like I'm going back to Brazil. Take me to Sao Paulo. Gomez, the cheap Messi seems pretty fitting. If you enjoy a classic number 10, this is it. With the 5-star weak foot, he fits the bill. Pay the tab. Stop complaining. And he comes in at nothing. You're getting a pretty unique maestro, someone who's gonna dominate. He's gonna rock the boat, rock the ship, take you to the championship on the edge of that box. Fine tuning. You need the details? The particulars has those. But at the same time, you are a little more limited as to what positions you're gonna use someone like Gomez on the virtual pitch. His versatility could be challenged. Play him as a number 10, classic center attacking mid, maybe something on the wings. I don't think he's really qualified to be a striker. Chiesa. Wow, what a magnificent young talent. Now with 5-star skills, decisive, explosive, dynamic, bright future. I rate this man. Some of this is definitely real life discussion. In FIFA, you're gonna have a good time. Very talented on the ball. One of the drawbacks is he has high work rates. I don't like that for attacking players. It would not be my number one preference, but because of how skilled and how technical Chiesa is in terms of what he can do when he gets the ball, I still feel like it works. That could be a little bit debatable. I think everyone will respect what he's able to do on the pitch and the virtual pitch. Lukaku, second come, at least for the usable Lukakus. I didn't think there would be a better variation or iteration after the team of the season. I was wrong. Here we are. Unorthodox, unusual, big body, very physical, kind of a specialist in certain regards, but now with the skills and just the pure power, put your head down. You've got yourself a rhino or a moose that's got a speed package, cheetah tendencies. Tyrannosaurus Rex? I don't think that really worked. Or a raptor? We should have stuck with rhino. That was our closest comparison thus far. Big, wide, physical, strong as an ox. We're really forcing some of these analogies or comparisons to strong animals. Please don't start talking about elephant. It doesn't need to go there. It's not necessary. Or giraffes, or camels, or llamas. Lukaku deserves this placement. Sterling! Now coming with 5 and 5 to go with 99, 99, 99, 99. One of, if not the fastest player in the game, with every upgrade you could ask for in terms of giving you that turn, that movement, that creativity, the orchestration. Phenomenal attacking player. You're going to see glimpses of everything that you want to see a glimpse of. This was a massive upgrade, and that's why the price tag also shot through the roof. But it's worth spending the money on this new roof. And was there even a shadow of doubt with nasty Neymar, one of the meta players, if not the most fitting for FIFA greatness in this year's installment? Neymar has every statistical increase or upgrade and improvement, accolade, recognize him, appreciate him, change the way that your team plays. Any attacking role, he's going to be better than everyone else in that role. We're kind of at that point with Neymar upgrades and improvements. And it should be said, he wouldn't be a detriment if you were using his standard gold foot item. Even right here, right now, you might prefer someone else, but he's definitely not costing you games. However, if you can afford one of the many upgrades, you will receive a better performance. He's a confident stand-up comedian. We've been all over the place in this video. Seems like a good place to wrap it up. If you enjoyed everything, make sure to drop some love, please, and thank you. I look forward to the comments. We have been grinding. We are still uploading daily. We got our first glimpse of the FIFA trailer. It's not a lot in there to unpack, so I'm not sure if I'm going to do a YouTube breakdown. Maybe I'll put something out on Twitter or IG. If you're linked up with me, if you're not linked up with me yet, at Mike LaBelle. I appreciate all of you beautiful, beautiful people. And we will have a merch drop, if you made it this far, at the beginning of next month is the plan. I need to take some pictures. But going forward, that's what I'm going to look to do, is once a month have a new product that comes out that I then can distribute to all of you. And we really push our community forward. I have a lot more content coming out ASAP.